So internbase will do level 2, challenge 1, the Rocketeer. Let's read the briefing. The Rocketeer. So we've been working with a well-known space flight agency to help us launch a satellite into space. The satellite will monitor criminal cyber gangs and help us in our effort to preventing large-scale attacks. They have a command that triggers a launch sequence, and the command is launch rocket. Can you figure out how we can run it so we can send the satellite to work? So the tip is we have to use JavaScript commands and in the console. So that's actually a pretty big hint. So the console is usually in the web developer tools, so we can access that by clicking inspect. And then the console's over here. And this is the HTML code behind the website. And we can also access the JavaScript code in the console. So let's look at the command that we need to run. We need to run launch rocket. So interesting note here is this is a function in JavaScript or a command. And by adding those parentheses, this calls a function. Let's see. Great. Our launch has been launched. And here's our flag. Great. So in this challenge, we have learned how to use web developer tools and a little bit of coding. Let's go to the next challenge. Hello. In this CyberStart cybersecurity tutorial, we'll be covering internbase, level 2, and challenge 2. Let's read the briefing. So we've been detecting a strange signal coming from deep space, and the satellite software isn't working correctly. So we're unable to target objects from the region of space the signal is coming from. So our goal is to try selecting them in the space scene and find somewhere to put the coordinates. Interesting. Okay, so we can see that when we select them, we get coordinates. And we even see the coordinates here, but we have to input the coordinates manually. So one thing that we could do is explore the Java code or the HTML JavaScript code behind the website by using the web developer tools. But that may be a bit too much. So let's try the simplest thing first. And looking at the URL, we actually see that there's a place for the X and Y coordinates. Let's see if this is where we need to put our coordinates. And that would be 385. It's acquiring. Okay, so this is the wrong one. Let's try this one. 9240 and 645. Let's see if there's a hint in the web developer tools on which one. No, we don't see one. So this is also incorrect. Let's just try, I guess, brute force and see which coordinate works out. So 850 and 565. Okay, let's try the blue one. So 440 and 445. Let's try this one. 610 and 665. And let's try this asteroid over here. 420 and 755. We'll try this one here. 735. Great. So we have essentially try to figure out where to input the coordinates. And in this challenge, we learn how to manipulate the URL. Great, so see you in the next challenge. Hello, in this CyberStart cybersecurity tutorial, we'll cover the internbase, level 2, and challenge 3, galactic greetings. So let's look at the briefing. Upon locating a strange signal from deep space, agents from the Cyber Protection Agency have been trying to make sense of its output, but have failed so far. So we think the output's encoding using binary, and our goal is to decode the output so we can read the hidden message. So it's a tip to search the internet for tools that can decode binary. So let's analyze the signal first that we've been getting. Interesting. So we got a binary output. So a simple thing we could do is use a binary to text converter. For the binary and convert. So what is 12 minus 8 plus 1? So that will be 4, and then plus 1, so that's 5. So let's try 5 and see if it works out. Interesting. So here it gives another hint saying that the output has to match the input. So let's also send it back in binary. So this time we'll do text to binary, and instead of just putting number 5, let's do 5. So let's see if this binary decoded message and encoded message works. Let's try just the 5 then. Great, so I guess we didn't have to use the word form. So in this challenge, we learned basic decoding and encoding. See you in the next challenge. Hello, in this CyberStart cybersecurity tutorial, we'll be doing the intern base, level 2, challenge 4, rover rodeo. So we can see that there is a rover that we have to control, and the software used to control the rover wasn't completed in time. So our goal is manually instruct the rover using the browser's console. A tip here is use the browser's developer console. So that gives us a hint to directly go to the web developer tools and head over to the console. And usually it's probably a function we need to call. So let's explore. So let's say move. These don't seem to be doing anything. So let's try rover. And let's see if there's a hint. In the rover interface, we can see that there are other functions we can call. So like there's a position and etc. So here we see that there is a drill function. I would assume we would do that when we get to the flag. There is a move function that takes in the length, so an integer. And then there's also a turn function, so it could turn. So let's try this. So let's do rover.move, and let's move it to, because we'll go up here. Great, and I think we have to turn the rover now, so we'll do rover dot turn, and let's do it right. I believe that's how it works. Okay, and we can press the up arrow to go back into commands we type. So rover.move. Let me press up arrow again, and this time make that left. And this time we'll do rover.move, but we only need to do it once. And now we need to turn right again and move up twice, or move to the right twice. Interestingly, something happened here. A mineral deposit has been detected. Drill down to collect the sample. Great, so now we can use the drill function. So we actually didn't use that before. So rover.drill. Make sure you have your parentheses. Okay, it looks like it has completed drilling. So let's do rover.move. Great, now we need to turn to the right. And let's continue moving. This time we'll just move one. Now we need to turn to the left. So let's go back up a bit. And we can move forward 3 times this time. And we'll turn left. And I think this should complete it. Great, so we have completed this challenge. In this challenge, we have learned how to manipulate the web developer tools and a bit of coding. See you in the next challenge.